when you're offered an alcoholic beverage on a plane, it's hard to say no. You know, you spend hours and hours crammed into an economy class seat, and a couple of drinks might just be the best way to pass the time. The effects of alcohol are very well documented, like this video of Australian TV personality Andrew O'Keefe enjoying just a little too much of the sauce a few years ago.
Well, as we say in the kiwi fruit growing business, you know, you've got to take it where you get it. And, you know, I'm like, dude.
Oh, right.
Careful, Andrew.
So what happens when you have a few too many on a plane? Most flight attendants will only serve a few drinks per flight, usually around mealtime and very few in between. Is this because alcohol gets you more drunk while cruising at 30,000 feet? Let's find out in this video.
Hey, you know, I heard when you drink at high altitude, it hits you even faster.
Woo! Party! I love you guys! You don't know how much you mean to me! You think you're better than me? Why can't you hit a curveball? I've done nothing with my life!
Alcohol is one of the world's most popular legal drugs, and for good reason too. When it's consumed in moderation, it has a laundry list of pleasant side effects. Of course, some of these side effects aren't great when you're operating heavy machinery like cars, but if you're a passenger in an airplane, well, you don't really have to do anything but sit there and wait to get to your destination. Air travel is one of the few places in the world where day drinking is widely accepted. When you're crammed into a tiny little metal tube for hours on end with hundreds of other people, it seems like a great idea. Now, a number of scientific studies have looked at the effects of alcohol at different altitudes, and the scientific consensus is alcohol doesn't get stronger as you increase in altitude. It's the environmental changes that are imposed on your body at higher altitudes that make you more susceptible to alcohol. When it comes to drinking, there are two key factors at play here when you're sitting in a plane. The first is the lower air pressure, and the second is the drier air within the cabin. Commercial airliners normally cruise at around 30 to 40,000 feet, but the interior of the cabin is pressurized to about 8,000 feet to ensure that the air is breathable. So this means that you might get into a plane close to sea level, but the actual air inside is the same air pressure at 2.5 kilometers above sea level. Higher altitudes can make you more affected by alcohol at first. It's because of the lower oxygen in the air, which means that there's lower oxygen in your blood. And your body can take at least 48 hours to acclimate to this atmosphere change. One of the physiological responses to a higher altitude is that you tend to breathe faster in order for your body to get the same amount of oxygen into your lungs as you did at a lower height. And this feeds into another factor at play here, dehydration. The relative humidity in a plane is far lower than at sea level. This is because air above 30,000 feet has virtually no moisture within it. So as the plane's air conditioning systems take in air from the outside and recirculate it with the cabin air, the relative humidity drops considerably over the course of a flight. A general rule of thumb is that you lose about 1 liter of water for every 5 hours of flight time. About half of this is lost through your eyes, nose, and mouth, especially because you're breathing more as the altitude has less oxygen. If you're not constantly replacing this water over the course of a flight, you'll get dehydrated very effectively. But even so, with less water in your blood to dilute alcohol that you've consumed, you'll get drunk a lot faster than at sea level. So to summarize, your body takes about 48 hours to get used to a higher altitude, and that just isn't enough time to get used to cruising in an airplane. So it's not the drink that's making you drunker, it's the heights that you're soaring to. Thank you for watching this quick and simple video, and if you are drinking on a plane, make sure you drink responsibly and stay hydrated. The drier air in an airplane can really dehydrate you and make some really bad hangovers, so be sure to keep a lid on that. And if you like this video, make sure you subscribe because there's lots more coming over the course of 2019. I'll see you in the next video.
Guess I'll just go back to coughing.